I've never really got on with keyboard shortcuts, and I know that's a shameful admission for somebody who spends so much time editing photographs and using programs like Photoshop and so on that absolutely depend on keyboard shortcuts, but I've never liked them. And the reason that I don't like them is, I think, because a keyboard shortcut breaks the intuitive link that you have between your eyes and between sensory input into the mechanism by which we're creating an action. Now, I see people younger than me with their fingers flying around the keyboards editing at a rate of knots, and I have never really understood how they do it, to be perfectly honest. So if I'm using Photoshop, I have a keyboard combination shortcut list on the desk next to me, and refer to it, which rather takes the speed advantage away. However, the end is in sight. I've got a new gadget, and this was sent to me by a company called TourBox, and it really is quite a remarkable thing. Now, what this is fundamentally is a collection of buttons, dials, shift keys, and so on, which can be combined in any combination in order to match existing keyboard strokes, keyboard combinations that are used by a program. I plugged it in and got it up and running. A very simple process. It instantly recognizes Lightroom. It's pre-programmed with a set of useful workflow tools for Lightroom. And it's configurable to set it for any combinations you want. So you can, once you get the hang of it, you can go in and change them. I'm going to show you how to do that in a little while, but initially I just wanted to have a quick demonstration of this, because it really is quite a remarkable little gadget. Okay, so let's have a look at this picture. This is raw, this is straight out of the camera. We can see over on the right-hand side, I've got a reasonably good distribution of tones and colours. Well exposed, it's a little on the bright side, but not very much. So let's see how this pans out. So what I want to do is to bring out the sort of aquamarine tones here. In particular, it's a bright sunny winter's day. I want to, it looks like a rather cold, grim, icy day here, so I want to make this somewhat different. So let's have a look at the white balance. Okay, and I'm going to take that down to around about 4700, I think. And now I want to go present, so texture I'm going to take down to a couple of notches. Okay, so texture is -3. Come down to clarity. I want to go up with my clarity, so I'm going to put this up to 48. With my dehaze, I'm just going to pull dehaze out. I want some dehaze round about there. That's beginning to look in, to get in the ballpark now. Now I want to go to tone, so hit that, and I'm going to come down to global saturation, and I'm going to saturate this. Bring this up to 45. Yeah, that looks nice. I'm going to go up to contrast and add a little bit of global contrast there. And now I want to do some fine tuning on the colours. Okay, so let's go for my blue, come down to do the hue, and I'm going to pull that to enhance the aquamarine color. I'm going to desaturate it a little bit. And I'm going to push the luminance up a little bit. Okay, perfect. I want to also show you how we set the program up. So this is the TourBox console. And that's the first thing that you install. So what we've got Photoshop presets. But let's have a look at Lightroom, since that's what we're really concerned with. We've got the schematic here. This is showing you the top surface of the button, and all the controls are labeled. And what we're dealing with is a very, very large number of possible combinations, right? So the side button is what we're using most of all at the moment. So we've got the knob here, and knob press, so you can press the knob in the middle. Now, if I move the thing here, if I go onto one of these things, it will take me to the control in question. So I click on the small, stubby little control on the right-hand side, and that turns out to be called short, and there it is on the schematic. If I want to go to C1 and C2, I think that's the buttons there. There's C1, there's C2, there's top, there's scroll, there's the knob, and here's the dial. These are the controls we've just demonstrated a lot of. Okay, and that's the, if you like, the side button, which gives us a different set of controls. Okay, so these are all set. Right, so we've got all these settings there. Now these give us some actual actions and some equivalences. So I'm not going to spend too long on this, because I think this is a case of me wanting to diagnose, if you like, my actual workflow, and then work backwards from that to work out what are the appropriate combinations on the console. But there are some that are set. So I can, this one, I can go side, if we look at the schematic, side, whoops. Look at side and tall will copy my settings. Side and short will sync the settings. Okay, so this is against anything that I might have selected in the film strip below. Okay, let's take this down. Now the kit section is where it gets interesting. So I can come in here. So we've set our up, down, left and right buttons. So the up will invoke the white balance controls. The down will invoke the tone controls. And we can see this corresponds to up here. Left gives us the presence controls. Right gives us the color mixer. And these are all the controls that I've just used to grade that photograph of the water of the fountain. We've got C1 and C2 set to undo and redo. We've got spot removal set, the adjustment brushes, radial filter. So this is the top button and the left button. Graduated filter, orientation, the tone curve, calibration, detail, color grading, point color. So there are times when this is easier to do with a hybrid approach where you can use the, in my case, the trackpad on the mouse. So if I'm going to do something like the tone curve, I can do this to invoke it. Let's have a quick demo. So the tone curve is side button and down. So let's go into Lightroom and let's hit the side button and down. So these tools mirror one another. I can go here, go there, just bring up those darks a little, and bring up the shadow a little. But you can see how that's being mirrored in the parametric curve over here. Here we are, that's the button that gives us the combination. It gives us the tone curve, so it's left hand and bottom of the four squares. It's previewing the panel here, and here we are in the tone curve, and it's giving us highlights, lights, darks, and shadows. Okay, now if I add here highlight split, I get that appears mid-tone split and shadow split. So that's these bottom three here. Let's go back. That's the current button. So we'll close that. We'll leave that as it is. Calibration, that is side button plus left hand. There is the equivalent. We find it in here. It's here, and we can see that all of the controls here have been turned on. So what we're expecting to find here is global tint, and then red primary, so hue and saturation, green primary, hue and saturation, blue primary, and blue primary saturation. So that's exactly as we would want it. But you can see how easily this can be programmed. So if we go back, and I'll just demonstrate how we can we'll close this. Right, we've got here a combination that's not set. So this is the C1 button and the short. So we go here, we click on this, and we can choose anything we want from here. So if I go into detail, I can go sharpening amount, sharpening radius, sharpening detail, sharpening masking. Okay, let's just go with sharpening here. So I can change this, I can name it sharpening. Okay, and that will now be mapped to that button. Okay, so there it is. So that is C1 and short. Let's go and have a look and see how that works. Okay, so C1 and short. And here is my sharpening panel. Okay, let's do it with the wheel. So take it to the amount, so we'll dial that up. That's beginning to look quite sharp in the corner there. Radius 0.8, I'll take that to 1. And then detail, and we'll dial that up. And that's now looking quite sharp. So that's basically how you program TourBox. Now, it requires a bit of analysis, but there is a lot of very pragmatic, very practical on-screen help, and that is to be applauded. It makes the job really simple. Okay, so in single screen mode, I can still make some improvements on the real estate, because the thing here is that what this enables me to do is to invoke these floating panels, these sort of smart mixer. So if I go to tone here, I've got the tone panel up here. I don't need to go burrowing around in the controls over here, and in fact I don't need them at all. So let's close some of these down. Okay, so here we are, we're now operating in sort of hands-free mode. So I can go to my color mixer here. I've got three sliders for each of those colors that I want to play around with. I can bring up my presence controls, texture, clarity, dehaze, vibrancy, and saturation. And I've got my overall white balance. Go to system settings. Go to displays. And you'll see that it's picked up the LG HDR screen as well as the built-in display. Now there's a little bobble there, a little arrow. It tells us that all these settings are applied to the built-in display and all these settings apply to the HDR. So this monitor is configured as an extended display. This monitor is configured as the main display. Now, if I just take this window, you can see that it appears on the other screen, and I can just wind that back. Now let's have a quick look and we'll see how this works with Lightroom. Okay, so here's Lightroom. What I can do is I can simply press this control, number 2, second screen, and I get my picture up on the extended screen, and I can use that screen to get a better look at the picture and a better view of how that's going to work. Yeah, well, thanks for watching, guys. I've really enjoyed making this video. I think TourBox has definitely got something for me. I'm currently using it really around the basic part of the edit to prepare the photograph for what I often take on to using masks and so on and so forth. But I can see it's really useful, and the one thing that you will have heard me complaining about before in relation to almost every photo editor that I use is the calibration of the sliders, and TourBox totally resolves that problem. It's quite remarkable. So anyway, if you found this video useful or interesting, give us a like down below and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos about photography.